kumbungga aku diuoi thaba hai na aku sama le kasi was the light that has a kam kam tau da no am ai ani la to ya ki am ma ta ngai la ki tau da ni ala ma tu ki khon si sun tau si tau si tau si hai na sun khau ki na sahi a to ni kai
Congratulations, sir, for being the new member of Rajya Sabha. What is the significance of today's visit in Humo?
It is nothing special because in the evening, today's evening, I feel something very extraordinary. What I thought was that I have to go to the house of my elder brother. I mean, and the chief of Hunfung for seeking his blessing on my success as a member of Rajya Sabha. So I came here. Today's visit is very surprise visit. Nothing to be planned. It's very surprise. Only to seek his blessing as an elder brother.
First of all, you're a Maharaja. What made you join politics and what kind of politician will you be?
For the last 25 years, I have been the Maharaja of this state without any power or money. And I have visiting or maximum number of villages, both in the hills and the plain. And I have seen so many things in the hill also and in the valley also. And I could not do anything remarkable for them as a Maharaja because I have no power, I have already told you. So this time, the central government and the state government, the present state government, I think they have come to realization that our Maharaja is doing something for the state for the last 25 years without any power and money. So we have to do something for him so that he may be able to do something for the people. So I think giving ticket to me is an it is an offer, respecting my, honoring my service to the people. So I think so. And they gave me the tickets of Rajya Sabha in the as a BJP. So I accept it because I think that, this is my golden chance. And God has also given me this chance to serve my people. Which I could have not done for the last 25 years in my life. So this is my golden chance, and I think I would be able to do something for my people, both in the hills and the valley, and in my prior interview, I have already told that I would do everything for the people of hills. Because the valley people are, when saying this, I do not neglect the valley people. They are already developed. And our peoples in the hill, in the interior, in the remotest place, I visited the Kasofung also, which is the extreme, which is border with the Myanmar. I have visited in the year, I think, 2002 or 2003. I have seen so many things which are not one to see. So, I would do everything for my hill brothers and sisters as an MP of the Rajya Sabha.
Sir, if I'm not wrong, you are the first Maharaja from Manipur joining politics while holding the same positions. So, as you had mentioned that you were offered a ticket by the BJP, right?
Yeah.
So, what was your first reaction when they offered you to join the party?
I feel very happy. I feel very happy at the time because I think that it was golden chance for me. This offer would help me in serving my people. So I heartily accepted their offer.
Once you were launched in the politics, there were lots of, criticism from the people.
Yeah.
You know, who were fondly following you for the last 25 years.
Yeah.
So how do you handle that situation by then?
Yeah, it is democracy. It is democracy. It is their right to come and negatively or positively. I don't think deeply in that. So everything is, I think it is the blessing of God. It is the planning of God. So I have to go. I have to go and they have to criticize by what? The democracy. It is their right to criticize me. So I don't think so much in that.
But do you think that when you were launching the politics, the state government as well as the people of the state, you know, give you the maximum support to be in the politics?
Most particularly by the brothers and sisters of the Hill, they are supporting me. When I was in a very distressed and a very confused state before election, at that time, my brothers and sisters from the Hills, they are coming to my house and console me. They are praying for me. They are giving blessing to me. And they are showing their solidarity with me. And they are encouraging me. You should go as a Maharaja of Manipur to the parliament as a lone member, a lone MP of Manipur. So this is their saying. So they encourage me. Brothers and sisters from the valley, they said that you should abdicate my throne if you want to go to parliament. And if you don't want to go to parliament, then you should remain as a king. Either or. If I go to parliament, then I should abdicate my throne. And if I don't like abdicate my throne, then I should not go to the parliament. This is their either or. But my brother and sister from the Hills, they are saying like not like this. They are encouraging me. You should go to the Rajya Sabha as a Maharaja of Manipur. So that is the thing, that is the difference. So I think that I would do maximum whatever I can as a member of Rajya Sabha for the peoples of the Hill.
You have been elected as the lone member of Rajya Sabha from the state.
Yeah.
Now, as a politician, what is your future course of plans? As well as being you are still the Maharaja of Manipur, how are you going to balance as a royal, as a Maharaja and as a politician?
Politics and Maharaja is not a different thing. You know Rajniti. Hindi mein Rajniti hai, or English mein politics. This politics is the game of Maharaja. Since 1949, when we merged to India, at that time we avoid politics and concentrate to customary things. Actually, politics is our game. Our Maharaja, our forefather Maharaja, our kings of Manipur. They ruled this state in a different politics. in a different way. They are doing politics also. So this is not different things. Politics is our character, and I will bring all this politics and the duties of a Maharaja, balancing with a balance. And first I would serve my people very honestly, very sincerely, and very transparently as a politician and as a Maharaja. This is the same thing. This is the same thing. It will not be different.
So you mentioned that you've got majority support from them.
Yeah.
So what is your opinion on delimitation? Because that's the current topic with the Hill District people.
But delimitation, I don't like to comment about the delimitation. I think it is something earlier. But I suggest to the state government that a state population control board should be formed in regard to this delimitation issue, so that unwanted circumstances may not become in the state. So I will comment it later more. I will not comment here about this delimitation, because it's very very sensitive issue.
So recently there has been some news that 3 MPs from the Northeast, including you, would likely, you know, get a cabinet berth in the center. What do you say on this?
Yeah, I have also heard it, I have also learned it. But personally or individually, I am not doing on the race. And you know this Hemant Biswas and the Agatha Sharma, they are very influential persons. I am a very new one. So it is up to the central leaders. The central leaders, if they love our Northeastern people, they are also Northeasterners. But if they love more than other states and love Manipur more.
What will be your priority focus as an MP?
Yeah, I have not a specific one, but I will do. I have already told you that I will do whatever an MP can do in his purview. I cannot do beyond my capacity, beyond my power. So I will do everything, all these things for my people in a very transparently, very seriously, very honestly, and very sincerely for my people. I will do which you have not seen for last many years. So that is my promise and my wish. And I would like to appeal to all the people of my people that please believe me. Instead of talking much, I would show you by action, by action.
Very short message to the people in the hills, because after you have been elected as an MP, this is your first visit.
Yeah, from time immemorial, we believe that our hill peoples are our brothers. So this brotherhood relationship, it should not be broken at any cost. It should be strengthened in the future also. It should be this bond of love between the hills and the valley people. It should be carried down generation by generation. And we have to do many things in keeping this relationship in the future, generation by generation. So this is my appeal to the general public. Yeah.